been very good, and you're headed there for a couple games now. How confident are you in this team in these travel games?
You know, as confident, I think, as you can be. Obviously, you never want to be overconfident, but I believe in our leadership. We're coming off of our first loss of the season. So, you know, when you lose a game, your team, it's natural that you're shaken a little bit, you're upset a little bit, you're mad a little bit. And those can all be good things. But I think our confidence is still in a good place. And that comes back to our leadership and our mentality and our focus. Yet at the same time, we know that this league is a bear. And anytime you go on the road in the league, it's a tall challenge. But our focus is exactly where it needs to be. And I'm confident that we're going to come out ready to compete on Friday night.
Coach, it seems like every week Julie Echols picking up another conference award. What makes her so good in goal?
You know, this might sound a little silly, but goalkeepers are kind of like wine. They get better with age and experience, you know. And Julie's a fifth-year senior, and she's very intelligent in the goal. A lot of good goalkeeping is about preventing and organizing and preventing disasters and bad situations. And so her confidence and knowledge over time has grown so much. And then, you know, she's got the fifth year senior thing going on where, you know, she's incredibly focused on being great, and she's incredibly focused on our team being great, and she wants to be the best season of not only her career, but the best season for Tennessee soccer in the time she's been here.
Coach, obviously coming off that tough loss to Auburn, how have you seen the leaders and the team respond to that loss in the last couple of days, specifically the defense, which played so well going into that game and had a tough one?
Everybody's been great, and it started in our post-game huddle. Obviously, we talked about a few things on the field right after the loss on Sunday, but then a couple of the older kids chimed in, and they talked about how our response needs to happen that day, that Sunday night, with our rest and our recovery and our rehydration, and then our focus on Monday in training, and it's been just that. So, as you said, it comes down to the leadership and the players within the locker room, and how do they want to respond, and how good do they want to be, and that's where I feel good about our team going into this weekend, because I know our locker room and the mentality of our locker room is in a very good place right now. Well, you know, Dave Hart and this entire administration is all about one athletic program and one Tennessee, and an investment in every single team and sport from top to bottom. And Dave Hart and our entire administration, it's a competitive bunch. And so it doesn't matter whether they're talking about the women's soccer team or the football team, those guys die to win. And so they're going to make the investment and give us whatever we need, all the tools we need to help our teams win. And it's nice to see Rob getting off to a great start. You know, it's been a rough couple years for that program, but that guy just keeps plugging away. And so it's nice to see the fruits of his labor kind of paying off for him right now as they get ready to start SEC play. You know, we stay in touch throughout the year. Typically, we get into our seasons and we get lost in our own world. So he and I haven't connected a whole lot in the last couple of weeks. But throughout I was in his office at some point this past summer, just talking about life, talking about teams, talking about how we do things within our team, rules, standards, expectations, things like that. And that there's value in that within any athletic department, within any coaching staffs. And honestly, I wish we did it more. And that's no knock on our department. That's happened everywhere I've gone. It's so easy to get lost in your own world and put your, kind of nose to the grind and just plug away. But when I ran into to Sam Winterbottom the other day at my daughter's cross country meet. And it was great because we wound up talking for 20 minutes just about recruiting, about our teams, and about life. And those kinds of conversations they're very rich, and they're very helpful always to all coaches.
Coach, you talked on after the Sunday match that you didn't think your team was – we weren't ourselves. Mm-hmm. What do you want to see in this next match that maybe was lacking a little bit on Sunday?
One word, and that is just energy, you know, and with that passion, fight, heart. And I know, you know, that might sound too simple, but the reality is when you're, you know, in college athletics, you know, especially when you compete and when you leave it out there and you fight and challenge for every ball and you move passionately off the ball to help your team keep the ball and you talk and you communicate and you connect and you play with discipline, you give yourself a chance. And I think there are a lot of those elements on Sunday that we're missing in our play. And so as we look to Friday, we say this to our team, if we play with passion and energy and fight, then we give our soccer a chance. Then we give our talent a chance. And I don't know that we gave ourselves a chance on Sunday, really. And so I expect us to come out with massive fight Friday night at Mississippi State.
Coach, are you at all surprised at how well your team has played, even despite the loss of Hannah Wilkinson? And what is her role, if any, within the team right now?
Yeah, you know, obviously in our first two games, really, we lost Hannah in a preseason exhibition. And then the first half of our first game, we lost an incoming freshman, Maya Neal, who we expected to step in for some of, if not many, of Hannah's minutes. And then we also lost a kid named Michelle Christie, who is in this Vol Leaders Academy, and she's one of our top two or three leaders on our team. She went down with an ACL 6 minutes into our first game, and Michelle plays in the center of midfield. She is kind of the glue within our team on the field. And in the sport of soccer, you play two 45-minute halves, no timeouts, no time to kind of regroup. So many things are happening within the flow of play, and that's where Michelle, being a very intelligent communicator on the field, that too, in addition to losing Hannah's production and goal scoring, losing Michelle's on-field leadership was really big. And that could have been why we tied that, had a disappointing tie in that first game. So we're bouncing back from a couple of different things. And so, yeah, until, you know, 3 days ago, we hadn't lost. We played 8 games without a loss. We'd only given up one goal. So, yeah, maybe a little bit surprised by that. But we talked about it. You know, we didn't want to hide from those realities. We wanted to kind of call a spade a spade. Hey, we've lost goal production. We've lost on-field leadership. We need both of those to be filled by any number of different players. And everybody has stepped up and done really well. Yeah, we laid an egg the other day. And you know, that happens. It happens in college athletics. It happens in professional athletics. It happens in life. You just got to learn from it and get back to work, as simple as that sounds. But again, that starts with team chemistry and leadership and your culture, and I think we're in a good place.
Coach, what have you seen from Ariel so far after she transferred in and sat out the year last year?
Tell you what, when you talk about fight and energy, and we've been talking about, you know, as a staff, Ariel Kupritz has been here now for, this January will be 2 years, okay? She too, tore her ACL 3 months into her stint here. So she was out for 6 months. But I don't think Ariel's had a day in training or a game where she has not shown up mentally ready to die for it. And while that might sound simple, it's not. These are kids, you know, and we're all human beings. I mean, you can never, you know, release the human reality to anything. You know, we've all had bad days at work. That's life, you know. Ariel shows up every single day ready to compete. So far, we've played two SEC games. We have two SEC goals. Ariel has both of them, and they're both spectacular goals. Arguably, I think we have 19 goals on the season. They are probably two of the top four goals on the season, if not the two best goals on the season that our team has seen so far. So there's value as a coach knowing that, okay, we're about to play. You wonder, okay, are your kids ready to play? Are they ready? Are they tuned in? Are they dialed in? Are they ready to communicate? Are they ready to connect? Are they ready to fight? We know every single time we step on a practice field or game, Ariel is ready to fight. And the kid, she plays with this pretty serious lower leg issue, which is called compartment syndrome. So after about 12 or 15 minutes, Ariel's lower legs go numb. And so if anybody's seen many of our games, sometimes she'll just kind of drop to the ground, and that's when we know we've got to take her off, because she can't feel her lower legs. So we let her play pretty much so she can't feel her legs. She comes off for 15 or 20 minutes, and when the legs come back, we throw her back out there again. And that speaks to kind of what that kid is all about.
Coach, you've got a redshirt freshman in Anna Bialczak. Can you talk, and she started all 9 games this season. Can you talk a little bit about her play on the field and how she helps your team?
Yeah, she's probably our most kind of from dead stop to first 5-10 yards, our most explosive, powerful kid. And then she's also proven to be a very good passer of the ball. I think right now she's leading our team in assists. She's got a couple goals as well. That was a heartbreaking loss for us last year. We expected big things, but she had to miss last year with injury. And, it's always a bummer when you miss a kid for a year, but it's always great when that year ends. Then you know, okay, I get you for an extra year now. And so knowing that she's only a freshman and we have 3 more years with Anna Bialczak, 3.5 years, including the rest of this year, she's going to be a big-time player in this program. She's also a very versatile player. She's good on the ball. She's, like I said, one of our best athletes. We right now been using her up top a little bit in midfield. We talked going into the season, we wouldn't be afraid to drop her into the back line if we felt like we were suffering back there. Obviously, we've been great in our back line and we don't need her, and we're able to use her higher up the field. And obviously that's paying dividends, 2 goals, 5 assists thus far.